How are you?
I'm Carolyn Toll Oppenheim. We are on the grounds of Abundance Farm, which is connected to Congregation B'nai Israel, but this is a community event called Harvest of Hope, and it's celebrating the harvest and interfaith work on the environment and sustainability and food security in our valley.
Hi, my name is Rabbi Jacob Vine, and this is an interfaith procession to celebrate the harvest, celebrate harvesting hope.
Well, you're going to be part of our parade.
All right?
Yeah!
Okay. All right, we're going to give you a pillow.
There's other groups that are processing, and we're going to process, and we're going to sing.
Welcome everybody. What a beautiful day. It's a tremendous honor and blessing to have today as our distinguished guests, Rabbi Everett Gendler and Mary Gendler here. For the past 50 years, Everett and Mary have worked together to be leaders in the civil rights, peace, religious renewal, and environmental movements. In the 1960s, Everett was a pivotal leader organizing active Jewish involvement in the civil rights movement, including facilitating Rabbi Abraham Joshua Heschel's participation in the famous march from Selma to Montgomery. Rabbi Gendler is also the father of the modern Jewish environmental movement, practicing and promoting Jewish environmental thought and behavior for a very long time, long before any of us were thinking about this, paving the way for projects like ours. And since 1995, Everett and Mary have been involved in community education work among the Tibetan exiles in India on strategic nonviolent struggle, where they travel regularly. You're heading back to India in a few weeks. They're on their way back to India in a few weeks. Also of particular note, and it's really impossible to begin to share the amazing work that the two of these beautiful people have been involved with their entire lives, but a particular note for us today is as we celebrate the culmination of, since May, a number of us have been working together on this interfaith initiative culminating in today's celebration, that Everett and Mary for the past 50 years have been actively involved in many interfaith efforts, including Everett serving as the first Jewish chaplain at Phillips Academy, Andover, as part of a Catholic Protestant Jewish tri-ministry. We are so incredibly grateful and blessed to have the two of you here today. And Rabbi Everett and Mary are going to read our Hakel proclamation.
The circle, inclusion. Earlier, Rabbi Jacob had mentioned convergence as from the four corners of the field, people gather and come together. Sukkot is actually a wonderful festival of convergence. And let me simply mention, without expanding, that what you experienced this morning with the processional, with the willows, was part of an ancient rabbinic rain ceremony. And I had actually prepared a small discourse, better for seating than for standing, another time. But please, I guarantee you that you don't have to travel to the Southwest to participate in an indigenous rain ceremony. It is called Hoshana Rabbah in our tradition, and every element is there for another occasion, a wonderful study session. The other element that I must mention, and after this we'll read the proclamation so beautifully composed by David Arfa. I don't know if he's here, but I hope so.
No, he's in Brattleboro.
Each year, in our Sukkah, you will find the illumination provided by a Jacob lantern. Now, a lot of people use electric lights. I propose those were not native to the ancient harvester's hut. On the other hand, something from the gourd family certainly was. Look at Jonah and the gourd vine. The fact is that there are elements of thought that parallel exactly elements of All Hallows Eve, Halloween, including the seven nights when we invite the return of our ancestral spirits, the Ushpizim. Again, a subject for study, but let me mention Raphael Patai and Theodore Gaster have assembled marvelous material. So we realize Jack, that's a contraction of Jacob, Yaakov. And so in our Sukkah, illumination is provided by candles protected by a creature with Star of David eyes, the nose, the usual mouth, and in the back, a grand Star of David. So I mentioned the Jacob lantern as yet another element in this wonderful convergence of history and nature and the primal element with which you are so blessedly in touch as you come under with Justin David and Jacob Fine, as you combine the rootedness in the soil, the religious worship, public education, the provision of food for those in need. All of this is convergent, and we feel blessed to be among you on this day.
We'd like to invite up to join us in singing Noah's Cargo, Reverend Andrea Vazian from
Haydenville.
I was going to say Holyoke, from Haydenville Congregational. Come on up, along with some representatives from Edwards and First Churches.
A little late, you know, I was 70 when I
got here. We are saving Noah's cargo. We are saving Noah's cargo. We are saving Noah's cargo.
Children of the earth.
Children of the earth.
Whales and wolves and owls and otters.
Whales and wolves.
To the earth. So, between each Oshana, I'm going to blow shofar, assuming I can get a sound. And are the seven people ready?
Yeah.
So, together we say, Hoshana!
Hoshana!
Please save the azure of the sky, the brightness of the heavens, the dark from electric lights. Please save the clarity of the sky and the radiance of the earth.
Hoshana! Hoshana! Hoshana.
Hoshana! Please save the oceans from runoff and the seas from plastic, the rivers from fracking, the aquifers from desiccation. Please save the clouds from withholding rains, the storms from bringing deluge, the deserts from spreading. Hoshana!
Hoshana!
Hoshana! Please save the soil from erosion, the microbes and mycelia from our poison, the ground from being paved over. Please save the farmland from industry, the cities from smog, the mountains from mining.
Hoshana!
Hoshana! Please save the summer from scorching, the spring rivers from flooding, the winter snowpack from melting away. Please save the fall trees from hurricanes, the crops from desiccation, the forests from clear-cutting and conflagration.
Hoshana!
Hoshana! Please save the salmon when they spawn, the deep-sea creatures from oil, the fish from red tide. Please save the penguins from homelessness, the sea turtles from sickness, the walruses from starvation. Hoshana!
Hoshana!
Hoshana! Please save the beehives from collapsing, the bats from fungus, the tigers from extinction. Please save the elephants and the rhinos from poaching, mighty species and small ones from murder. Please save the humans from our foolishness, humility from arrogance, love from hatred and despair. Hoshana!
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 Teach us to rest and release.
Please save, nurture the abundance of life and strengthen the weave of all living creatures. Hoshana!
Hoshana!
3, 4, 5!
Repeat after me. Kol mevaser!
Kol mevaser!
Mevaser va'omer!
From when Leander Grinspoon Academy was Solomon Schechter Day School of the Pioneer Valley. Old, old, old. So for those of you who were part of the community then, please join in. It is around, and it's a beautiful song, a nice way to wrap things up.
There are just a number of people who we really need to thank today. And we are going to have a whole afternoon of fun after this. So please don't leave after this. There's still climate ribbons to be made. And at 4 o'clock, if you want to gather and share your climate ribbon wishes for the world, you can do that. At 3:30, there's going to be a tour of the... So thank you so much to all our volunteers. They deserve a big round of applause. Thank you to the people who staffed all the tables and all the vendors. But also, I just really want to say that this has been a 5 to 6 month effort with a number of interfaith partners. And I just want to make sure we read all their names. So thank you to First Churches, Edwards Church, Haydenville Congregational, Florence Congregational Church, and to the three sponsors of Abundance Farm, Congregation B'nai Israel, our home right here, the Lander Grinspoon Academy, and the Northampton Survival Center. Abundance Farm couldn't be here without you. Thank you all. Enjoy the rest of your day.
So who are you?
I'm Everett Gendler. What do you mean? I mean, yeah.
So you are a special guest here and speaker today at this Harvest of Hope. And I understand from not only what you had to say or the introduction, that you've really been a light in the Jewish Peace Fellowship and the Jewish contribution to the whole discourse on peace and justice making.
I've had that privilege. In the course of my studies, but also just because of the trajectory of my life, I was introduced to this material. It helped guide me, and I've been blessed to share it more widely with others, both in the realm of peace and the mandate to seek peace and pursue it, and also for many decades the environment as well, and a peaceful, respectful treatment of that.
Now, what do you have to say today when we are probably in one of the most aware that we're living one of the most critical times ever between the environment and the ongoing wars that are being perpetrated around the world by this country we both live in?
What I say is that we need to address the problem at its source, at its depth. And the depth and the source were articulated by Isaiah centuries ago when he said, God created the earth to be inhabited. And that's the key. So, Syria, the crisis, was partially precipitated by the 4 years of drought and the inability of the Assad government to respond. And that, of course, provoked a variety of reactions. Alas, many of them self-destructive. And the result is now a human calamity of immense proportions. But we need to address both the environmental degradation there, but also the fact that the continued fighting worsens, aggravates the situation, and no one will win. And you can go around the globe and isolate with analysis the number of places where this is the real issue.
Now, Carolyn, you had a question you wanted to ask.
Yes,
what was that?
I believe that Rabbi Gendler was involved with Dr. King and was down south.
I had the privilege
of being in prison, right?
I was jailed with him. Well, no, I was arrested with him in Albany, Georgia. But once we were all booked, then we were resegregated blacks off to the Terrell County stockade, whites off to the Lee County stockade, or vice versa. But, you know, one old southern chain gang house equals the other.
So what do you think, if you were preaching today, you would encourage young people to do?
Well, I would certainly encourage them, first of all, to be in touch with their deepest inclinations. I think for any one of us, it has to start with personal tendencies, preferences, and then see which way those lead. Look at possibilities for addressing the issues of the world constructively in accordance with your own passions, and see if, as one of my rabbis, Henry David Thoreau, put it, see if you can get your living by loving while preserving the planet.